weapon of valor? Is your armor intact?
Yes.
Do you have on the breastplate of righteousness?
Yes.
Are your feet shod with the preparation of the gospel of peace?
Yes.
Are your loins girded about with truth?
Yes.
Do you have the shield of faith?
Yes.
Do you have on the helmet of salvation?
Yes.
Do you have the sword of the Spirit, which is the word of God?
Yes.
Enter, men of valor.
Jesus, so men of valor through the Holy Ghost, men of valor through our Jesus, so by the power.
That once there was a man named Naaman, who was captain of the host of the king of Syria. Naaman was a noble and honorable man, and God had given deliverance to Syria through him. Most of all, he was a mighty man of valor, but he had one disappointing characteristic. He was a leper. Leprosy, a dreaded disease, starts with a sore, develops into a scab, turns bright white, begins to eat into the flesh, exposing raw flesh. Toes and fingers begin to fall off, and there is also excruciating pain.
Oh, I'm so tired of this agony and pain. Oh, somebody.
Of God, he decided to compose a letter to the king of Israel, for he felt that if all these things were so, surely the king of Israel would see to it that Naaman was healed. So he sent Naaman to Samaria along with silver and gold and expensive raiment valued at over $3 million.
Thank you. Thank you. says the Lord.
Yes.
Come on. Now.
Yes.
Just like I said, I do it just
one Lord, one faith, one baptism, one God and one Father of all is above all and in you all. One is for unity. One is for one accord. One is for one day I will be like him. One day I will be caught up. For one thing have I desired of the Lord, and that will I seek after, that I may dwell in the house of the Lord all the days of my life. That's one time. Two is for intensity, a double portion, a double anointing. Two is for the number of witness and testimony, for we need at least two witnesses for every word to be established. That's two times. Number of divine manifestation, for he is Father, Son, and Holy Ghost. He is prophet, priest, and king. He is the way, the truth, and the life. That's three times. Number of universal extension, for they shall come from the north, the south, the east, and the west to worship the God of glory. The four winds obey him. The four living creatures with their four faces do his bidding. He is God. The number of restitution in order for restoration to take place. That's five times. One less than perfection and completion, for man can never make this journey alone. That's six times.
Oh, my Lord.
And I won't spare.
Concerning the seven parables, he then departed into his own country, and it was there he learned about the beheading of John the Baptist. After hearing this, Jesus and his disciples once again departed into a desert place. As Jesus sat by the Sea of Gennesaret, a great multitude gathered unto him. They came from throughout every city and village to see and hear the great teachings of this man called Jesus. The blind came, the deaf came, lamed, diseased, and many near death traveled far in hope for a new life. Jesus had healed all that had come to him, and through his great love and compassion for mankind, he also fed over 5,000 with just 2 fish and 5 loaves of bread. Now stands at the Sea of Gennesaret speaking to his disciples.
Even now, you look upon me without understanding. For have you not heard the words that were spoken unto you? And have you not seen the things that were done before you? Many of godly men have longed to see what you have seen, to hear what you have heard, but could not. Be not as a seed that is planted among the thorns, but be as a seed that is planted in good ground. For blessed breath or your eyes, for they see.
Hallelujah.
And blessed are your ears, for they hear. Now go. Get into the ship that is before you and sail to the other side.
But Master, why sendest us into this ship and not come with us? Are thou angry with us?
Why, Master? Why dost thou send us out unto the sea? I do not understand why you must leave us at this time.
Master, what shall we seek for on the other side? And who shall guide us when our journey? Shall we wait for you to have us leave?
For have you not heard the words of which my Father has spoken unto you? To give unto you instruction for your journey. For if you have ears, listen.
As Jesus looks upon his disciples with a saddened heart, because even now they doubt and question him, Jesus not only has to deal with the doubt and insecurities of his disciples, but also the sin of the world has been placed upon him. Jesus turns from his disciples and goes into the mountains to pray as his disciples get into the ship to continue their journey.
nor the lesser ones be seldom brothers. For we've gone some distance, I believe too far. For
no! A great storm approaches!
Oh, sure, I should not say this at this time. What can we do? He can't help us in this hour.
Jesus is with you. Be not afraid. Jesus.
Jesus. Jesus and his disciples continued on. Jesus and his disciples continued on until they reached the land of Gennesaret. And when the men of that place had knowledge of him, they sent out into all that country round about and brought unto him that they might only touch the hem of his garment. And as many as touched him were made perfectly whole. The moving of the water. For an angel went down at a certain season into the pool and troubled the water. Whosoever then first after the troubling of the water stepped in was made whole of whatsoever disease he had.
Somehow, in the moving.
A certain man was there which had an infirmity 38 years.
Lord, forgot me again. No one to carry me to the pool, Lord, and now I'm just all alone. God, isn't it enough that I have this crippling infirmity, God? Why? I had it so heavy upon me. My friend.
Almighty God.
and ruler of the council.
Yes, but I wasn't sure at all costs. I must be seized with the right people and the right way.
And I just, you know, my brother.
Grant, just Grant. After all, you know, today is the Sabbath.
Wait a minute. Wait, here comes.
Thank you.
from his mother's womb was carried, whom they laid daily at the gate of the temple, which is called Beautiful, to ask alms of them that entered into the temple. John, who had recently been filled with the Holy Ghost, went up together into the temple at the hour of prayer, being the ninth hour.
Peter, is it one of you? Praise the Lord, Peter. I can't wait to pray in the temple again.
Yes.
It seems that since we've been filled with the Holy Ghost,
hallelujah,
the whole foundation of the temple changed. Remember, they didn't even teach. Anyway, it's time to go and pray.
Yeah.
I'll run with the Pharisees.
So strong, so cruel. Silver and gold.
of the immortal words, let there be, to the miraculous parting of the Red Sea, to hear the children of Israel tell the story of God's amazing grace and Shekinah glory. From walking in the wilderness without being reshod can only be the work of the Almighty God. From the crumbling of the walls of Jericho to telling the children which way to go. From healing the sick to raising the dead to remit our sins, his blood was shed. From the hanging of Jesus on Calvary's tree to the precious Holy Ghost that he gave me. Until the dead in Christ are called from beneath the sod, we are kept by Jesus, for he is all.